So, this afternoon I wanted to see if we can gently encourage our minds to incline a bit further towards loving kindness and away from ill will, away from any of the harmful emotions that cause anguish, that cause difficulties for us and that lead away from nibbana. So far the guidance has been quite light, and I may give a little more this afternoon, but please just take this as an invitation, as a suggestion. And if your mind is already inclining in wholesome ways and inclining to stillness, just allow the words to drift over you, through you, and carry on in the way that works for you. But for those who wish to follow me in this little meditation, we're going to just bring up some thoughts of loving kindness in the beginning of our practice, hopefully to energize the mind a little bit and direct it onto a wholesome object before allowing the words to fade away and the feeling of metta to continue. And with that feeling of metta, you can see what happens. Maybe the breath will arise, will enter your mind. And that too can be held in a field of loving kindness. So just beginning the meditation by landing in your body. Sensing your body as a whole. Noticing your posture and whether there's anything you can do, any slight adjustment that would help make your body more comfortable and at ease. And taking your time with this, because this develops a relationship of trust between your body and your mind. And your body often gives you feedback. So just sensing the body. Perhaps gently scanning your body from the top of the head all the way down to the tips of the toes. And as mindfulness flows down, experiencing all the various sensations along the way, it's accompanied by kindness, by warmth, a sense of gratitude, respect. allowing your body to deeply relax. And delighting in that feeling of deep relaxation. Softening and deepening more and more fully into this present moment. And sensing in to your own goodness. Perhaps bringing up any quality or virtue that you really value and respect. Perhaps your sincerity in practice. Or your intention to try and live kindly. perhaps you're very careful to speak the truth, be someone who others can trust. Whatever it is in your own heart that you can really appreciate and respect, just connecting to that. And allowing that recognition to gladden your heart, uplift your mind. And if you wish, with that sense of respect and friendliness towards yourself, you can gently wish yourself well, using some simple phrases of loving kindness that really resonate for you, with your deepest wish for well-being, contentment, or perhaps peace. Phrases like, may I be happy, may I be content, just very gently planting these phrases like planting a seed in the depths of your heart. Just nudging the mind towards those thoughts and feelings of loving kindness. And listening in the space between each phrase to allow the heart to open to the feeling, the emotion of loving kindness in its own time. Just happy to plant the seed. And staying connected to your own heart center, to the area around the chest. Tuning in to any sensations, any feelings associated with loving kindness. If you wish, you can bring to mind a very dear person in your life. Perhaps someone who's helped you, maybe on the spiritual path. A teacher or a wise friend. Perhaps a best friend or a nephew or niece, anyone who merely by recollecting this being brings a smile to your heart. And imagining them sitting in front of you. Perhaps recognizing some of their beautiful qualities. Or maybe noticing how you feel in their presence. Safe and at ease. And from deep in your heart, just wishing them well. If it's helpful for you, then using some directed thought, thoughts of loving kindness, benevolence, well-wishing. That are tailored just for this special person in your life. Repeating each phrase clearly, rhythmically, sincerely. And just listening deeply. In the gap between each phrase, to allow the heart, the mind, to incline to loving kindness. And as the feeling of loving kindness grows, you may need the words, the phrases less and less. Doesn't matter either way. Every time there's a thought or intention of goodwill, you should feel glad, confident, even inspired that at that time no ill will can be present simultaneously in the mind. You're pointing the mind towards happiness, away from anguish and toward nibbana. So just continue practicing however is suitable for your mind at this time. Perhaps dropping down to a single word as the mind quietens. Or simply allowing the breath to enter your mind as another object of loving kindness, as the mind settles and quietens down. just as in all kinds of meditation, just notice if you're trying a little bit too hard. And relax that extra effort. It's enough to be friendly, to have a kind disposition to whatever you experience. Giving metta just to give metta without expecting any special feeling in return. Or staying with the silence, staying with the breath, just to be with these beautiful mental objects, the way you'd give company, loving company, to a very good friend. Not being proud or demanding in nature, but being contented and easily satisfied. Contented just to give yourself fully to this moment, whatever it is. And now, as we come close to the end of the meditation, just bringing your mind back into your body sitting here. Into a friendly presence with your own sense of being. And perhaps smiling into your own heart with a sense of gratitude and appreciation for your own goodness, your own virtue, your own humanity. Wishing yourself well. May I be happy. May I be free. May I see the Dhamma. May I be at peace. And sharing these good wishes with all beings everywhere. May all beings find true happiness in themselves. May all beings be free. Free from danger, sickness, free from harm. May all beings who realize the Dhamma may we all find true inner peace. So maintaining these attitudes, these thoughts and emotions of loving kindness. When you're ready, you can gently open your eyes. Be kind enough to yourself to have a cup of tea, if you're English. Or not.